In this video, we talk about whether Jake Paul and Logan Paul are good or bad for boxing. Be sure to like and subscribe if you enjoy.
Jake Paul and Logan Paul, the narrative that they're not good for boxing and the sport itself. And I just want to have a discussion, see what we think about that. Obviously, Jake and Logan have been boxing for a couple of years now, making tons of noise in combat sports in general, not even just boxing, also the MMA world. Of course, Jake Paul calls out Conor McGregor and all these guys, you know,
Nate Diaz,
Tyron Woodley, Ben Askren, you know, he fought two of those guys. So I feel like them boxing, I feel like it is good for the sport because, you know, in general,
it just brings so many more eyes, especially with Logan's like fight with Floyd Mayweather, arguably the biggest star in boxing ever.
Yeah.
And it was him to get that fight even alone was like insane.
Yeah.
On paper, it looked like not even real. It made no sense, but to see him like get that fight and to, even though it was just an expedition, at least exhibition, at least he kind of held his own in his own way, I'd say. And I'd say it's good for boxing. Jake and Logan are good for boxing because they're just helping to bring more eyes to this sport, which those new eyes could become more hardcore into boxing and get into the more in-depth fighters and the guys that are more popular within the sport itself.
Yeah, for sure. And I feel like, and they're not taking it as a joke, you know, they're going in real training camps with, you know, real sparring partners, real teams, you know, they're not treating it like it's, you know, just another thing, another day in the office. They're going hard, they're working hard, and it's showing because, you know, they're at a level where, okay, you can tell these guys have been doing it for a couple of years now. They're not any amazing pro level, high level guys. You know, they're still amateurish in their skill department, but you can tell they've been doing it for a while and they're taking it seriously. They're putting in the work. They're treating like professionals with full fledged training camps, licensed pro fights. You know, they're really doing it. So I feel like them saying they're bad for boxing isn't really fair or giving them the credit that they deserve for what they're doing.
Yeah, like I see where some of the more like boxing fans will say it's because maybe some of the things they say, which to a point it's true, because if you're just looking from the outside eye without knowing anything about like the YouTube world and how that drama kind of works, you can be like, oh, these guys are just coming in and just saying a load of crap to all these
super
skilled fighters that dedicate their entire lives to the sport, and they're just coming over here and getting all this noise in about. But if you really like look at it and just see like they're beneficial by them just kind of helping to bring more people attracted to the sport itself.
Yeah.
And that's, like you said, they're not taking it as a joke. Like they actually have training camps against high level opponents for their skill set.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like to be fair, like to Jake, like fighting Tyron Woodley, who's 5-time UFC champion, even though sure not a boxer, but still super high combat sport athlete, to fight him so early in his career is quite incredible, actually, and just putting on for, like a event of that scale.
And for Logan Paul to get in there with Floyd Mayweather, I mean, probably the greatest to ever do it, right? And we're talking about him versus Logan Paul. Obviously, a huge size difference with their height being, you know, 5 inches, 6 inches apart, and their weight being like 40 pounds, 50 pounds apart. So you know that was a huge size difference, but I feel like it's good for the sport. Maybe not those kind of fights, those exhibitions where we're having, you know, a legend in there with them, because you know they didn't necessarily earn the spot, but at the same time, like if the money's there, it makes sense. So I feel like them they're taking it seriously, and they're not bad for boxing.
Yeah, to them, they're also taking the opportunities they get. Like, it's not like anyone else in their position would turn down a fight with Floyd Mayweather, money and stuff. So, yeah,
or Mike Tyson. You know, there's rumors of Logan Paul fighting Mike Tyson, which I'm pretty sure he declined now, or he said that's not going to happen. So, yeah,
which I think personally is the right idea, since it would just
it doesn't really
like,
make
even
sense.
Even the Floyd thing, it doesn't make sense. Like, and Tyson's even older, and
it
doesn't make
Mike
sense.
Mike Tyson's
to me,
55
so.
Years old against, you know, you're gonna put him in against a 26 year old. That it makes no sense. You know, 38
years
apart.
Just, Like, I get, like,
And
Floyd's more for the money. Like, I see why he would do it, but to
yeah,
see
for sure.
Tyson going, like, it's like
Yeah.
against Logan Paul, it's just, I don't think it's
Yeah,
right.
Floyd's whole narrative, his whole career was, you know, his name was Money Mayweather, right? He fought Conor McGregor, a UFC star, obviously, and now fought Logan Paul. He doesn't really care who he fights, because he's gonna, if he makes money, then he's happy, you know. And
Yeah, and his legacy
he's
is already well in set.
yeah,
So
and it also brings the younger generation into Floyd Mayweather. You know, these guys that only know YouTube. Okay, well, Logan Paul's fighting Floyd Mayweather. Let's see who Floyd Mayweather is. Always the best boxer. Let's watch him. Let's watch his fights, you know. So
yeah.
even though he's fighting a YouTuber who shouldn't be in there with him, it's still like bringing eyes to both boxing and the fighters.
I fully agree.
This clip is taken from the Punch Plan podcast, which you can check out on screen now, or you can listen to it in the link in the description on Spotify. Also, we are posting tons of different things related to the podcast on all of our social medias, including TikTok, Instagram, and Twitter. Make sure to subscribe here and follow us there if you enjoyed.